Hi, I'm Anthony, Recovery Coach. I'm going to talk about what a recovery coach is. So see if we can actually define this thing, describe what a recovery coach is. Now, this is for me. I'm not representing the world of recovery coaches or the Association of Psychologists or coaching or anything. These are just my opinions, my 2 cents, if you will. Well, $2, two C notes, perhaps. It seems like a sense is not quite worth what it used to be, okay? But what is a recovery coach? A recovery coach is a private guide, a personal guide to your recovery and beyond. Why do I say beyond? Because a lot of people have the idea that recovery is about, you know, just stopping the alcohol. Here's a little tip, perhaps the better recovery coaches don't talk about, or the worse recovery coaches don't talk about. I don't know. We'll let you determine that. How much do you think I talk with my clients about alcohol or booze, like in a percentage of the time in our sessions and a percentage of the amount of work that is covered in the assessments and so on? Is it like 100%, 80%, 50%, 20%, 10%? With me, maybe 10%, maybe 15 on some, you know, when I'm doing assessments, it's probably more like 20%, you know, 25%. It's on, you know, I'm assessing how much they're drinking and so on. So there's it's more weighted toward drinking and drug use. Agreed. I'll grant that. But the actual sessions, are they about drinking and drug use? Not mostly. No, they're about the drivers, the things that are creating the solution called drinking, the solution called drug using, the solution called filling the pharma bottle down one's throat, one pill at a time, half a pill at a time, etc. Those are solutions. Drug use, alcohol use, is a solution, not a problem. Becomes a problem though, doesn't it? Comment down below if you have something to say about that. You know, drugs, problems, or solutions. Be interested to hear about it. So when we're dealing with recovery coaching, I'm dealing with all the underlying factors, the abilities, the inabilities, the awarenesses, the discoveries in the other individual, the untapping their innate abilities, their unlocking their innate wisdom, finding out that knowledge within, bringing those skills out to the forefront, exercising those skills with them, giving them things to do so that they can improve upon those skills, become more aware of them, get comfortable with those awarenesses. So when they see them and they are acting within them, they're no longer uncomfortable in reacting to them. They can simply be aware of them with no upset, no reaction. That's a definition of comfortable. They are aware and comfortable about it. And then they're aware. Now, if we want to level that up, we can help an individual become aware, comfortable, and able to handle and negotiate easily those situations. I don't have a problem going to a bar. I don't particularly want to go to bars or like them, but if I go to a bar, it's not a problem. I don't drink. People ask me, oh, you know, what can I get you to drink? Well, sure, I'll get a, you know, San Pellegrino, please. Love that. I don't drink. Any kind of, you know, I can't be coerced or convinced into it. There's no triggers there for me at all. I'm completely comfortable and able to negotiate that issue. Not an issue. Doesn't even trigger me. There's nothing occurs. That's a really good state for a current drug abuser, alcohol abuser, or pharmaceutical dependent individual to achieve and to actually level up into, where they're comfortable in the situation and they can navigate through it without need. They don't need to pop their benzo or their Ativan. Take a drink, take that hit of weed, snort that Coke, do the math, whatever, you know? So what is a private recovery coach then? Well, they're yours, meaning, you know, you work with them. It's not about anybody else. There's no reporting counsel, right? It's a confidential conversation. But a recovery coach and recovery coaching helps release an individual's potential. And it's that potential toward their own destiny that we want to not only uncover, but we want to enhance, meaning we want to get there faster. We want them to be their ideal person as soon as possible so they can live in their ideal life as much as possible before they die. You see, that is the definition actually of ethics, to live your life in your destiny before you die. To be unethical is to die before your time. Well, what is your time? Your time before your time would be before you have achieved your destiny, your ideal state, right? And you're living under that, right? So the sooner we get you to your ideal state and living in that, yeah, then you can level up. Imagine living several lives in one life. Ever thought of that? Comment down below. There's an interesting thought, right? Now, let me preface that. Several lives that you wish to be living. So, yeah, you can say I was I lived several lives as a slave, as a, you know, obsessed with, you know, compulsive on, out of control, unknowing, unaware. Okay, well, it's a life. I agree. Is it one that you wanted to live? Perhaps. Okay. Well, recovery coaching is not about those lies. It's about, if anything, it's about helping a person evolve out of and over those lies and get out of them. And so overcome those conditions, raise their levels up to higher capacity so they're living their destiny in a way that is behooving or suiting their quality of being, who they are. You see, when I look at someone or I talk to someone, I see the quality of their being, their highest level. And I'm trying to help them unleash it, untap it, see it for themselves, practice it, work with it, discover it more. That's recovery coaching. Recovery coach is a guide to your perhaps perceived potential and beyond. I'm Anthony, Recovery Coach, talking to you about what a recovery coach is and what we do.